is not too bad here.
It kind of brings that spring down.
Yeah, which a lot of them don't.
Basically, you're eliminating putting your finger right here and pressing down on the butt of the bullet.
And pinching your finger with Havians.
I never heard a real man complain about pinching his finger on the phone. Okay. Yeah. So let's put the bullets back in the Folgers or whatever that is, because you're going to want to shoot again down there.
Okay.
And let's put the gun into your holster. Are you familiar with the slide release and how to function your gun here? Come over here.
Okay,
so here's your gun. Now, I was telling your wife that you don't just give someone a gun. Here you go. Here's how you get someone a gun. Always safe zone. I stood back. Look around now. It's pointed in a safe direction. Always a gun. I don't go
it's
like
it's always this. Pointed
it's
away.
It's in a safe direction, not destroying anything. You can't call a bullet. One, two, three. And do it three times to make sure there's nothing stuck in there. Sometimes bullets get stuck in the barrel and they don't eject on the first time. So somebody like, look, I cleared it.
Three times.
So one, two, three. Okay, cool. Now on a locked slide back, I will manually hold the slide release up. That's what these little grooves are for. So I'm going to grab it. It's still in a safe direction. I don't aim it towards me. I don't aim it towards you. Push it back and stick the slide release up. Now I can look down the tube. If there's a bullet in there, you would see the bullet right there. You would see the back of the primer. You could see there's nothing in there, nothing in there. So now it is a safe gun. I am still going to give it to you like this in a safe direction.
And I'm still
going to
keep it in a safe direction.
Don't put your finger in the hole. Okay. Finger, nothing goes in the hole. When I give it to you, I don't care how you grab it. I don't care if you grab it here, anywhere. Don't stick anything in the hole. My fingers are in the hole. I guarantee like that. I will, at my time now, get away from the firing point. I go to your safe zone, which is either the side of you or behind you. And I expect you to always keep that thing in a safe direction. Don't seek yourself or a car or anything you can't destroy. Piece of dirt, no big deal. But so that's safe. Now, so get it firmly in your hand. Do not put your finger in the hole. Always keep your finger out of the hole.
Okay.
Hold it. No, don't let go. Hold it firmly. No. Put your finger on the front of the rim. No, keep your finger straight.
Oh. Okay. Well, I'll make sure.
There. That's where you're good. So just keep it up. But don't touch the rail. See the slide? This is called a slide here.
Don't touch that area.
Yeah, because this is moving. So you're going to let it go right now with your index or your thumb, whatever you feel comfortable. Point it in that direction, still safe direction.
Okay.
Yeah. Hit the slide release. Take that button and push down.
I heard that guy's pretty cool.
There you go.
Okay.
So now if he had the magazine in there, you would have sent a bullet home. Not fire, but you would have sent it to the receiver. Yeah, because it came out of the magazine and it went right home. And then it set up for single action. Now you get to pull the trigger.
I pull the trigger?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, that's called a dry fire. Now, pull the trigger again. Now stop. That was the easiest. That would be like maybe 2.5 pounds of single action. Here's double action. Now it's probably like maybe 8 or 9 pounds. See how hard it is?
Right, yeah.
I can't even pull it again. Can I use two fingers?
Yeah. Well, I guess you can.
There we go.
Okay, I never seen anyone do that. But
like a girl.
But that's the whole thing. That's a single action. Double action, so it's obviously much easier to shoot it when the hammer's back, right? So it's like maybe 2 pounds, and then this way it's like
semi-automatic.
Damn, 8 pounds. It's a big difference. So generally, when you're shooting a target in double action, going like this, you're gonna go. See how that works? So when you're single action, it's real smooth. And it stays straight. So if you're going to shoot anything, always shoot your gun. Just cock it back, because the first time you cock it, after you shoot the first bullet, it's going to stay back because it discharged the shell and sent the bullet wherever you're aiming at. So it's going to be back automatic. So then you just pull the trigger, clink, extend it straight. Now put your finger not on nothing that slides. This is a slide, so you want to put it just firmly right there. Because when this comes back, it's going to whoosh. And you don't want it up there because it's going to bite you. And you'll feel it. Because
right, it'll
the blood. Okay, so it should be in a safe zone. So this gun doesn't have a whole lot of real estate on it for your index finger. But that's
can I pull it back?
No.
No.
You could do that, but you don't need to. You have a slide release. I want to let you see what the slide release is. So here's a slide release. All you do is put pressure on this downward. So let's put back up. And now your thumb should be able to
put the pressure on it. If it can't, then use your other hand.
Okay, I'm going to do it.
Yeah, there you go. Now you would be totally loaded because the magazine would be in there, and now you are basically at a level one situation where the bullet would be in your barrel, but you are basically a single action, kind of like a 1911. The hammer's ready to go. So now, slowly pull the trigger, and what you're trying to feel is look at how much resistance there is on the trigger. So pull the trigger. Now go. Okay, pull it. Okay, so that ain't that bad. Now pull the trigger again. Big difference.
Because it's actually got to pull that.
Exactly. So now you went from a single action to a double action. This is equal to a double action. Do it again. Double action. And now let's say you already shot it. It discharged the bullet down the barrel and ejected the shell. Now, that would be a single action. You know, pull the trigger. Easy, huh?
Right.
Okay, so every time this bullet, you fire it off, it's going to cock the hammer back. And it's going to be like 2 pounds. That's what it is, 2 pounds, right? And it's easier for target acquisition. So you're up, ping, you can stay on target. Ting, 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 ting. Whereas you're going double action, like, and if you're left-handed, then you're, I mean, so it pulls to whatever side you are in double action. That's why you'll see most LEAL law enforcement officers, they all use, they precision use double action guns. And that's why really cops are such bad shots when they're under duress, which is natural instinct, right? You could get shot, but if you ever read the
you're
stats,
stressed out, you're under
it's stressed already. Yeah. And then on top of that, you're pulling 8 pounds every goddamn time. And so it just makes you even a worse shot. And this is like a real short little barrel here. Right. So we don't be discouraged if you don't hit nothing. But keep in mind, if you shoot a 5-inch barrel, that's a really good barrel to shoot.
Be more accurate.
A lot of people are like, oh, I want compact. Well, that's okay if you want a compact situation. But for accuracy, you should be either get proficient with your 4-inch or 3-inch or get a 5-inch. Only problem is 5-inch just can't stick everywhere. It's a lot of mass on your person if you want to conceal it. So there's give and takes to every situation. You got to find out what you want your gun for. But this stick to this here. Okay. So now you know the difference between single action and double action. Mm-hmm. You understand single action, like real light, 2 pounds, right? It's already caught. Double action, 8 pounds. And then you're going to be pulling if you're right-handed or if you're left-handed.
Or two-handed.
And I want to show you the two-handed motion, how to hold it. So most people, it's such a small weapon. This is about what you want one hand on. And it's a 9mm. So it's not going to go boom. It's nothing like that. You're going to shoot it. And a lot of people will go like this. And
there's
just,
very little
they get like a crane. And they're just straight. And they go like this. And they okay, this being a 9, it's not going to have that much recoil. But what you want to do is kind of hunker down and put the weight on your firearm. So you'll look at speed shooters that shoot all damn day or real accurate shooters. They don't go like this. They go like this and hunker down and they lean into it. So say all their weight is like here's your pivot point. And then so there's more resistance for the gun to go. And then you're rigid though. Okay, but then what they also do, they'll go around you. See,
Serpy, understand, muzzle safety. So now you keep your finger there. And what you do, and this thumb goes in the direction, should be parallel with your firearm. This other support hand, put it up there. Now, there's not a whole lot of real estate for you to put it.
Right.
Your palm should be on that spot. Now, there's nothing there because it's so small, but your thumb should both be in the same exact position, aiming parallel to your weapon.
So they're lined up.
Yeah,
like
your thumbs should be parallel to your barrel.
And so the thumbs should be pointing in the same direction of the barrel.
Don't be aiming it down. You'll see people aiming their thumb like down that. Like this. No.
No, you got to point it.
It gets a little awkward because it's such a small gun. Okay, right. It really is. I'll empty my gun. I'll show you the big difference with my gun because it has a little more real estate on it. So you put your hands on it.
But I actually want the palm.
So you touch whatever you can, but there's not a whole lot. Your primary hand is all reels that use everything up. Now what you want, it has to be underneath, kind of like that.
Oh, underneath.
Yeah, like so here. Okay. You see, nothing can be higher. This thing slides. If you have anything,
like that.
If you have anything above that slide, you're going to feel a bite. Then, oh, ow. That slide's going to come back, hit your knuckle. Your knuckle's bleeding. And then you're going to be discouraged to shoot it again. So you've got to keep in mind, feel comfortable, but everything has to be below that. Flip it over. Same, safe. Everything has to be below the slide. Don't put nothing above the slide.
Because the slide's a machine.
It's moving. Right. It's coming. Yeah. In perpetual motion.
And it's quick
fast.
And it's not going to stop.
It busts knuckles. It's a knuckle buster. So keep that in mind. So, okay, put your hand back up. Okay, so there you go. Cool. Now, that's it. Now, some people, because it's such a small thing, they grip really good. That's good. The first thing is keep your thumbs. Now, spin it over. Now, just a little. Now, let's get just the pad of your finger on the trigger. Don't put the crease on the trigger. And you'll see 90% of people shoot with that.
We'll put the crease because it feels
like
it. Feels
like it goes there, but no, it's supposed to be the pad.
And it's the crease.
The pad could go easier this way. Where the crease, you're going closer to the right, so you go like this.
And you can damage the crease, too.
So, well, I don't know about damage.
Well, also, too, when you have your... When you're shooting and you have your finger further to the right, you're going to pull to the right. If you have your finger over too far, you're going to pull to the left.
Okay. So
right
it's
in the pad, the
it's
center.
right in the pad.
Yeah, right in the pad. Just right there in that pad. And you should, here's one thing you should try to remember, too. Now, it should stay open after the last bullet. The slide stay open.
Yeah.
But sometimes guns don't. Maybe they're dirty, they fouled, whatever. So, they're... The slide went forward, and you're trying to have another shot. But if you could count your bullets, take your time. One, keep in mind, that was two. Last thing you want to do is when you're shooting, which I always see people, here's a gun, it's in my left hand, and they go, how many bullets was that?
Oh,
muzzle. I didn't hear it. It's in my left hand. What? See? And, no matter what, my gun's still pointing the safe direction. I'm talking over here. What? I mean, my gun. No matter what, my gun is
pointed.
Safe in direction. Never sweep anybody.
Okay.
Period. I can't emphasize that enough.
Gotcha.
So because, one second. But do you feel comfortable?
Yeah.
Can I give it to you?
Yeah.
Are you ready to accept it?
I think so.
Okay, here.
Well, then you have
exactly.
To have
I'm glad you did that because that's it. Don't accept the gun because you don't know. I can't emphasize the skill. And I told you twice, right?
Yeah.
Someone that knows what they're doing, they're not going to give you a gun. They're going to give you a gun. Then it'll show you. One, two, three. They're going to hold the slide back and then it'll show you. This way, now you know it's 100%. What? Exactly.
Level 3.
This is level 3.
Okay.
Yeah, repair them.
Level 2 is if you have a bullet in your mag and you stick your mag in the center and then. That would be level 2. Once you drop this slide release, send it up, now you went level 1. I want to give it back to you. Like, you had it, right? You look.
Okay.
Right? You're totally safe, right? You feel very comfortable? I should be checking it. 1, 2, 3. That's really the way it should be. Now I want to give it to you. Here.
I'm always in the safe zone. No, you could.
I can look down the barrel. I can see a little light. I don't see a bullet.
Right, because you'll see the bullet, you'll see the brass when that's in there, even though they're painted. So now go ahead, drop the slide release. Okay, cool. Now pull the trigger, dry fire. Okay, now you're totally safe. Now let's put the magazine into your gun if you feel comfortable walking in. Just don't put it, this is like level 3 right here.
Thank
so
you.
Now what I did is took one out of the magazine.
Loaded it.
I loaded it. That's level 1. And that's how it goes. So level 1 means it's a hot gun. The only thing that would prevent it from going off is your safety and your finger in the hole. So then if you go level 2, then you want to take the magazine out. And then you open the breech, hit the bullet out, hit the ground, hit the bullet up, and then that's level 2 because your magazine's still loaded. Just because your magazine isn't in your gun is still loaded by the law. I'm not sure if you know that. Now that's something different. So you can't.
So now what's loaded by the law?
Having this loaded, even if it's not in. We're loaded.
This is a loaded gun. It's not a loaded gun. Right? It's not
right.
A loaded gun.
Because
legally, I have
part
two
of the gun,
parts. This
it's
is a loaded gun.
Okay.
And it's as easy. It's going clunk and it's loaded anyway.
Okay,
yeah.
So it's just one step of technically being loaded, but legally, that's what you have right there is a loaded gun.
It's a loaded gun.
Okay.
In two parts.
I just want to make sure you understand that because a lot of people say, oh, I know now. I took a little class. It's like, dude, you had a loaded gun. It's the magazine, so they don't know how to decipher. That's why I'm trying to let you feel this is a gun. It's a lot of responsibility. If you're going to be holding it, playing with it, and doing anything, the best thing I could suggest is go to your local range and go see the basic firearm instructor and go get a CCW. And they're going to take you from the little tidbit I showed you, 100 leaps and bounds just from the legal aspect and how to carry a gun and how to go from level one, level two, level three, boom, 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 and to pull it up quick for a defensive scenario.
I would think any responsible, you know, gun owner that doesn't know anything.
This is a level three gun. You already know it's clear because you cleared it, right?
Right.
So this is level three. You go backwards. So level three. It's loaded up imaginary. Right? Now it's inside the gun.
Okay.
That's level two.
We need to load some mags.
Do you guys have ear protection?
How I have ear plugs.
Okay. Are you good? I need to finish my demonstration. She's almost done with the plate. Well, maybe not. You gotta hurry up. Oh, here. Let's get you. There you go. Eat in front of the camera. Say cheese. Yep. Mm, yummy.
Yum.
Delicious. He loves
cheese. Thank you, Dean.
But, okay, here's your gun, right? Okay. Do you feel comfortable with it?
Yeah.
Okay, if I give it to you?
Absolutely.
You really?
Well, you want to open it three times.
Okay, good. Yeah. Okay, here's yours.
Thank you.
Because it's a loaded gun,
yeah,
right?
I want it open.
Now, if she's holding that and I'm holding that, I don't have a loaded gun.
Yeah, but the fact is, well, you know, how do you know? Once I give it to you, unless I give it to you,
three
I verify there's nothing. So I did it three, there's nothing. Now it's totally safe.
Okay.
Right now, I'll give it to you, drop the slide, pull the trigger. Now you can holster it and snap it.
Okay.
And we'll just leave the magazine out.
I'm just going to put the safety on.
When you're taking the bullet and you're doing the slide, because before you're just dropping the slide, that was easy, just releasing the slide release. Now you're racking the bullet yourself. This is you. So you have to grab the slide and yank it back.
Okay.
This is called racking. You're loading your firearm.
Put it on top like this.
Yeah, pull it back. There you go. Manhandle it. Okay, one, two, but you're really covering up the port, so you
I couldn't really see.
Yeah.
There we go, like right. that.
One, two, that's a good pull.
That left, all the way like that.
Exactly,
okay.
But don't cover up the port. Okay. Now,
there we go.
Dry fire it.
Okay. Don't hold it like a gangster. There you go.
Now stick the magazine up inside. Okay, now you have to rack it.
Which was the...
Pulling the slide back.
Okay.
No, don't cover the hole.
Don't cover the hole.
And then let it go. Don't help it. Now, you covered up this hole. I couldn't see if you did. Let me take the weapon from you to see if it's loaded. So what we want to do is look at it, see if you have something in there. And your tube is still nothing. So you went...
I didn't go far back
You
enough.
Didn't go far enough to capture the bullet.
Okay.
So let's try it again.
Well, make sure you pull it all the way back. One step.
Pull it with
steps.
The goozer, not back here. It's still not.
It's not backing.
Just a
yeah.
Oh, you didn't stick the magazine in.
Hey!
It fell off.
Ah!
Okay, so
okay.
Let's try this again.
All right.
I hope you're going to edit this.
No, yeah, we're going to show because this is what people do, man.
Well, maybe.
That instructor was horrible. He still didn't do it.
There, I felt it. I saw it then.
You did?
I thought I saw it.
Okay, let's
pull
back, just
a
hair.
Visual.
Just check it.
Yep.
And you're good. See?
I did it.
So now, bring it out of your hole. Are you going to shoot with two hands or one hand?
One hand. I'm going to put the other hand over
okay,
here.
Okay, cool. Now your ears are in. Now it's double action.
I took out the one ear and I'm live. How do I put the safety on?
I'll hold it.
All right.
Let him hold.
Thank you, sir. I got excited.
That's okay.
Yeah, right hand. Are you doing? Okay.
Yep.
You good?
Yep.
Okay, now you're ready. You're locked, loaded. You're level one. Now
I'm ready.
To shoot.
Okay. Let me get my thumbs in place. It was get as much real estate over here and put this thumb over this thumb, right?
Point them straight with the barrel.
That was my five.
Yeah, one more in there or something. See, it's not locked back.
Did I do six?
You might have one in there.
Yep.
Now it's empty.
All right, cool.
And I'll drop the magazine.
See how it popped back?
Yep.
You push the groove area back. You pull it back.
Almost out.
Do they make more user-friendly,
yes,
easy-to-work guns?
Yes, they do. But this, I believe, was a Cold War gun in Russia.
Because goodness gracious. Okay, there we go.
Cool.
All right, now we're safe.
How many bullets are you going to give your husband?
I'm going to give him five.
All right.
I got six, but you get
I'm five. Five is fine. We still hadn't hit the cow pie.
It doesn't matter. You're
no, it doesn't
focusing
matter.
Focusing point that's irrelevant. We just want to get you familiar with your weapon.
Right.
That's essential. Well,
and to make sure that we operate it safely.
Yeah, you know what you're doing. Yeah.
Legally, because I have this loaded and a gun in my holster, I have a loaded weapon. Legally.
Legally, you have a loaded weapon in your hand. And it's not even in your hand, it's in your holster. That's what the law says.
That's what the law says.
Okay, get your footing, get your situation adjusted. Okay, now, so you want to try doing the racking without the magazine in it?
Well, the racking is what? Pulling the...
Slide back.
Back.
Slide back.
So
okay.
Let me hold the mag. Pull you up and out. Safe position. That's your
safety
primary
off.
Hand. Take the safety off. Get your support hand. Pull the rack back.
One.
No. Okay, no, you're
two.
Not trying to do that. You already know it's safe.
Okay.
Try fire. Okay, now grab it by the grooves in the slide. Don't do nothing right there. The grooves. Put your thumb on one side, index on the other with your support hand. Keep it in the same pointed direction. Racket, do not, no. On the grooves, not way over here. On the there you go. Not like that, but up. There you go. I'll make sure all this stuff is clear.
Oh, okay, so okay. I don't pinch myself.
Yeah, you don't want to bite, you want to hit yourself, take some skin off.
And I want something more user-friendly.
Yeah, that's a personal preference. If you need to go to an indoor shooting range, mm-hmm. rent their gun, buy their bullets, and then they'll hook you up with a variety of stuff.
See what I like.
Okay, here I go.
Okay.
Cool.
Hit it.
I knocked that.
Did it you was, make the cow
yes,
patty?
I knocked the
good
top
job,
off
honey.
The cow patty.
Yeah.
Woohoo!
So now just drop the slide release. Try fire. Now stow it.
Okay.
Why pull it out? You're going to put it away.
Because he keeps it separate.
There. So wow. There you go.
Yay!
Now I need to get a cleaning kit. Clean it
yes.
Out.
Make sure you get the right caliber, or the diameter of the brush for your gun. Now if it's 9mm, probably all nine. But I don't know. This is an oddball.
This is, it's. I think it's a Russian size 9.33.
Right. So tell your gunsmith, because I don't know anything about this gun. I just,
okay.
We both got familiar with your gun.
Okay.
Cool. What's good, like I said, is you have the best of both worlds. Single action, double action. I can't emphasize safety and responsibility.
I think they
showed
should
you,
teach that stuff in public
I showed,
school.
Well, they used to.
Right.
Okay. But this is something, these are the basic fundamentals. Once you get into other stuff, take your CCW class, and then they teach you how to go from level 2 to level 1 like I did. I mean, there's a lot of things you guys could do.
Okay.
But this is the first step, and I'm glad you guys actually brought your weapon up.